Last month's issue was our 500th. That issue had 24 extra pages of content, including so many wonderful and appreciated thank you ads, commemorating the 41 years we have been supporting officials and officiating organizations. Thus, this issue is number 501, and I wanted to inject a bit of a more personal note on this journey than I was able to do on this space last month. When you have been doing something as long as I have, perspective becomes a dear companion. What I know now is not what I knew in January 1976 when the first issue of this magazine was published. Lack of respect has pushed many individuals and groups onto the path of rebellion and remonstration. My remonstrations on behalf of improving conditions for the basketball referees in my group were pretty much fruitless, so I changed course. I became a publisher. Just weeks after the first issue of Referee came out, I received a call from the head of a nationwide governing body in the basketball world. He liked the magazine so much, he called to say that he was offering his organization's endorsement of it. I remember what I said on that phone call like it was 41 minutes ago, not 41 years ago. We don't need your expletive deleted endorsement. This publication is going to be by officials for officials. We will survive and thrive on that basis, or we will pack it in and start washing cars. And that is a quote. Over the years, it became evident that charting a course devoid of building relationships and alliances with organizations and key influentials that have a stake in officiating was wrongheaded and just plain stupid. I had to get over the insularity that naturally had come with being constantly put on the defensive as officials and from receiving virtually no support from governing bodies. We had to grow up. I had to grow up. In the beginning, we were just publishers. We produced a magazine and that was it. Then over the years, we became content producers. Magazine, newsletters, books, digital content, quizzes, videos, etc. We had our beliefs and our words spread far and wide. With such expansion came the need to be more thoughtful. I so clearly remember that in one baseball book we produced, we included language that called out a baseball rules committee as being dumb, in quotes, because of a rule change it had made. Now that was real smart. As the outside world began circling its wagons to keep us at bay, we had a choice to make: embrace different viewpoints or render ourselves an outlier. Do good things on behalf of officials through retaining a closed shop, in quotes, or do better things by inviting others into our store to discuss how we could together serve officials. We chose the latter. It wasn't easy to take that step. We celebrated our fourth birthday with a birth, one that would change all of us forever. The National Association of Sports Officials came from the simple idea of providing insurance protection and other benefits to officials and, of course, a copy of Referee magazine. In those early days of NASO, it really was, as I used to kid, the National Association of Referee Subscribers. Referee was the public face of our undertakings. When I was asked to address the media, it was as the publisher of this magazine. Then, inexorably, over the next 15 or so years, our landscape changed. Referee and its staff became the support team for all things NASO. The media turned to NASO for perspective. Yes, we were the same people doing both, but the focus was on the not-for-profit association we created, but which is now owned by its members. Today, 27,000 officials can proudly claim that ownership. The symbiotic relationship between Referee and NASO is efficient, bright-lined, and fruitful. Ensuring the health of both organizations has been challenging at times. We've pulled it off because of the integrity, the intensity, and the involvement of every person who works here. Without them, well, would we just washing cars? Thank you.